Alright, yo, what's good everyone? Nick Smith is back. Welcome to the NBA Online YouTubers League Fantasy Draft. This is where all of us YouTubers, I think there's 18 of us, I'm going to name them in a second, but this is where we have to decide who we're going to pick. Now, I was on the clock, I was pick number 4. I was choosing between Kevin Durant or James Harden. LeBron, Curry, Davis had already gone before me. I had to take the reigning MVP, Kevin Durant, over James Harden. Durant has way better shooting stats in the game for some reason. That's why I chose Durant. But I don't know. I did have Durant in the last online YouTubers league that I did, and he was a beast for me, so why not pick him up again? But this time, this YouTubers online fantasy draft, it's going to be hard, and it's going to be a lot harder than the other one I did for NBA 2K15. The reason being is the one I did for NBA 2K15, we had about, I think there was 9 of us in the league. Now we have about 18. After Durant, it was Harden, then Paul, then Westbrook, then Paul George, and then Wolfman chooses Melo. I'm going to go through all the YouTubers that are in the league in a minute, but I had to speed this up. I had to go for, like, this draft, let me tell you, it went for about 4 hours. No joke, the draft took about 4 hours. It was insane. 2K, we got to fix this, man. It was crazy, 4 hours it took. And by the third round, everyone was tired and getting bored of this. So, it was kind of funny. We were all in the Skype group together, talking and chilling about while drafting players. And it was fun, but it went for ages. And, you know, it was annoying because the player that you wanted, he would go to the next YouTuber. And then the next guy that you wanted, he would go to the other YouTuber. So it was hard to decide on who to get. And a lot of the time, I was struggling on who I really wanted to get on my team. And, but, man, 4 hours sitting in a chair waiting for your turn to be picked. It was actually kind of good. I got to edit a couple of videos, and I know that some other YouTubers were editing videos as well. Agent was editing some videos. The Gentleman TV was editing videos. I think Marcus was. So there was a whole bunch of YouTubers just editing and drafting players at this point in time. And then I was on the clock again. I need a center because the centers drop down dramatically once you go past, like, probably like the 77 overall range. The centers just dropped down dramatically. Rudy Gobert was on the block. I didn't want Joakim Noah. I didn't want whoever else was on the board beforehand. I wanted Rudy Gobert. He's a 79 overall. It wasn't a great pick, but look at the guys that were on the clock. I didn't really need any of them. I was thinking about Ibaka. I was thinking about, you know, Tyreke Evans, but I don't know, man. I think that Rudy Gobert, he's a good player, especially in NBA 2K. He can, you know, block shots like crazy. He's a good rebounder. He can dunk inside. He's athletic. Then I realized I saw Noel on the board at this point in time, and I was like, damn, I should have picked up Noel, but it doesn't really matter. I got Gobert, and I'll take Gobert. And, if you guys want to know who got LeBron, it was Crispy Flakes. He got LeBron James, and I was like, damn. But I already knew he was going to go first anyway. But you never know. I might be able to trade Durant for LeBron. If you want to see me trade Durant for LeBron, you can comment down below. But I don't know. I mean, we just started the league. Not sure if I want to make too many trades. I think I will, though, just because I'm not 100% sure on how I want to run this team. Now, at this point in time with my third pick, I was choosing between Drew Holiday or Brandon Knight. I needed a point guard. Isaiah Thomas I was thinking of, but he's too small in 2K in my opinion. He just gets blocked way too easy, especially for 2K16. Blocking shots is way too easy, so that's the reason why I chose Brandon Knight. And once again, I'm going to fast forward because this took forever. It was crazy. And this is about the time when we were all getting really, really bored and just wanted this whole thing to end. But it was actually quite fun though. I don't mind drafting players and things like that. I might do one with you know, subscribers one day. If you guys want to see one with subscribers, leave a like on the video and comment down below if you guys want to see me. If you guys want to, you know, join me and we can do one with subscribers and play against each other, draft players, and we might even be able to do it with legends. I reckon that'd be dope. Obviously, the person gets MJ. We got to make sure that guy doesn't cheese, but it'll be fun. I'll do that as a series one day, I reckon. But, this was crazy. And the thing about NBA 2K is players drop in overall dramatically, and it was crazy. By the time I was on my fourth pick, I wasn't, you know, really happy on the player that I chose, and it's kind of unfortunate, but it has to be done. You just have to choose the best player available, pretty much, or the player that you think is good to play with. Now, I'm not hating on anyone, but there's some guys in the league that chose players I would never choose to play with, especially in 2K, just because, you know, they're hard to play with in 2K. So, yeah, I don't know, but that's my opinion. Right here, I have a point guard, I have a center, and I have a small forward. I'm choosing between a power forward or a shooting guard. I see Gerald Green. He's an OP player in 2K. I'm going to take double G, Gerald Green. You already know, 96 dunk or something like that. He can hit the three ball. He's not great, but he's all right on defense. I'm going to take Gerald Green, the OP NBA 2K player. He's been OP for the last 4 years in NBA 2K. He's been OP for forever, it feels like. Gerald Green is a beast, and you're going to see that. When I play with Gerald Green, I like playing with Gerald Green, and I'm good at playing with Gerald Green, and that's the reason why I chose him. Obviously, there was better players on the board, but I reckon I play well with Gerald Green, and that's the reason why I chose him. Now, as you can see, Tony Allen's there, and we got Ryan Anderson, because we need a power forward right now. So I'm choosing between Ryan Anderson, Nene, Ed Davis, Taj Gibson. The thing is, I play my team, right? Domination mode, I got Nene. He's a beast. He can hit the mid-range jumper. His rebounding's not great in this, but he's good when I play with him for some reason. So I chose Nene. But hold up 1 second. You're going to see something crazy. You can clearly see right there, I chose Nene. It's on my 76ers pick right here. You see Nene, and then it just changes me to Tony Allen. What the hell? I was like, what? In the chat, not in the chat, in like the Skype thing, the Skype call, I was like, what the hell? They changed me to Tony Allen. And nobody really believed me, I don't think. But, yeah, they said I took too long. I could clearly see I chose Nene, but they gave me Tony Allen. So then the next pick, I had to go after a power forward. And I went for a guy that I've played with before, and obviously I play with regularly, Julius Randle. He's a rookie. Obviously, well, second year, but pretty much a rookie. Because he only played one game in his first year. Julius Randle, I chose Patrick Mills from Australia, repping Australia, Patty Mills, three-point cheese, you know how to choose him. Then I chose Tim Hardaway Jr. I don't really know why I chose Tim Hardaway Jr. I just kind of did. I like his form. He's all right in 2K. He's not great, but he's all right. And by this time, there's not many great picks available. So at the end of the video, I'm going to go through everyone's teams and all that kind of stuff. And yeah, by this time in the draft, everyone was bored, and we were just waiting for this thing to get over and done with. Then I chose JaVale McGee to end the draft, but that wasn't to end the draft. It was just, you know, I just chose JaVale McGee. I'm going to show you guys who I chose after JaVale McGee. I didn't record all of it because I didn't really want to record like 4 hours of the draft. So these are some of the YouTubes that are in here. The Gentleman TV, Westside right there, the Raptors, that's Agent Zero. We got Josh Nader, 7-11. We got, who else? Marcus 2K, Crispy Flakes, Waffle Man, Legendary EA. Plenty of YouTubers in this. And all of the links and stuff will be in the description box down below. This is my team. It's all right. I ended off JaVale McGee. Then I chose Granger, James Jones, and this guy right there. He's 7'4". I'm just going to cheese with him. I chose Montrezl Harrell just because I feel like I'm good at playing with Harrell. He's not a great offensive player, but on the boards, he's all right. And at blocking shots, he's all right. And I'm just comfortable at playing with Harrell. And these are some of the YouTubers. Marcus2K got Paul George. And I kind of want Paul George. He did offer me a trade, Kevin Durant for Paul George. But I don't know if I really want to take that trade, to be honest. I like Durant. And I'm going to play just a couple games and see how they do and how the team plays and all that kind of stuff. And then I'll decide on who to keep and who to trade. Waffle Man got Melo, Wiggins, and D'Angelo Russell. So, I mean, watch out for Waffle Man. Steph Curry's controlled by the CPU. Legend of Winning got Kobe. I don't think he meant to get Kobe, but he did. And his team's actually pretty nice as well. Let me know in the comment section, which team do you think is the best? This team is right here. It's nice. Kevin Love, D Rose, Crispy Flakes got LeBron and Ibaka. Agent Zero got Klay Thompson. DeMarcus, Bledsoe, Iggy. That Rockets team is nice right there. Aldridge to the Spurs. Chris Paul right there. So, yeah. Let me know which team won out of the draft. And this is TGTV's team. He's the Timberwolves. But, yeah, this is the draft. I tried my best to record it. It was hard to edit. Not really, but it was like 4 hours long, so I didn't really want to put all of it in here. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed the video and you want to see more YouTubers Online League, leave a like on the video. Subscribe if you're new. Let's see if we can reach 1,000 likes. I'm out. Peace. Like they can never even live up to logic. You bust, I dodge it. Think you seeing me now? You just mirage it. I'm gonna like a semi-automatic. That's putting your quip with lyricism to let them have it. I blast it. Any style that you coming at me with, I master. I sun motherfuckers, then I'm out on you bastards.
Psych. I'm just playing with y'all.
Yeah, you know I had to keep it going. Kick rhymes that blow minds, we see foreign. Real, recognize real, and you looking foreign. I was spitting flows before I was even born in the womb. And I'ma keep it up until the tomb. And as for the fame, yeah, I know it's coming soon. Cause I'm going in raw, finna bust up in your room.
Hey,
I hear the beat and it's urgent to emerge in the game. Puking the duke cause I'm too sick to spit that yoga flame. The way I see it, this is rap, second renaissance. Spitting dirty sentences, so ill they affect the medicine. Ha, I'm heaven sentence, spitting fire like a demon. As the internet allow my flow to get to streaming. I'm beaming, fall asleep listening. Now I'm in your head, what you dreaming? Leo DiCaprio flow, I'm up in that bitch scheming. Trying to get you to buy the album, trying to get you fiending. See my vision as I commentate it. You want a scene, they can rebut or debate it. But the hate, I ate it. Success is truly overrated. I seen cats that wanna blow up, turn pop and get deflated. Huh. See, yeah, you made it, but all of your fans hate it. And it's kinda looking like you and Satan negotiated. When it comes down to the rap game, you see I'm integrated. Half white, half black, I had to incorporate it. Get the money.
Whoever did this is a real pro.